know I'm a little late with this reaction because this album was released on January 12th, but I honestly haven't heard it yet, so I figured I'd do a reaction to it on a video. This album I'm about to react to is Camila Cabello's debut album called Camila. I've wanted to listen to this album for the longest damn time, but shit has been so damn busy for me lately, bro. But now, after this long ass wait, I finally have the time to listen to it. I'd say that Camila is my third favorite newer singer after Ariana Grande and Demi Lovato. That shit's irrelevant at this point because y'all came here for an album reaction. So here is my reaction to Camila Cabello's debut album titled Camila. The first song is Never Be The Same, and I already reacted to this one, so I'ma just skip over it. But the link to my Never Be The Same reaction will be in the description below. Alright, so the second song off this album is All These Years. Alright, so far I'm loving her vocals in this song. So far this song is very beautiful, man. I really love this smooth, chill beat. All right, man. All right. Ooh. Oh yeah, Camila's delivering them vocals in this song, man. Hell yes. Just a quick hello, and you had to go. I love how Camila is one of those newer singers who actually puts meaning behind most of her lyrics. That's another reason why she, Demi Lovato, and Ariana Grande are some of the best singers of today's generation. I mean, they go in very deep in, like, most of their songs, bro. Well, this song may not be a fast party song, but it still rocks, in my opinion. I love both slower songs and faster songs. Alright, so far this album is off to a damn good start, man. And this next one is titled, She Loves Control. Oh, damn, this song sounds like it has a tropical house vibe in it. Now this sounds like a party banger right here. Yes. Ooh, yeah, dude. Yeah, this beat is going hard as hell. You know, here, wait. Since this beat is so fire, I gotta do something. All right. These types of songs right here are definitely some of my favorites. It's very good stuff to dance to and put you in a damn good mood, bro. Ooh. This is another great song that has a good vibe to it. Next song off this album is Havana featuring Young Thug, and I already reacted to it, and I'm sure everybody else has heard it already as well, because this song blew the hell up after it came out, and it still remains a hit to this very day. But the link to my Havana reaction that I made last year will also be in the description below, but even though I've already heard it, we can listen to a little bit of it. Bye. Okay, before I get on down to the next song, I just want to make fun of Young Thug's verse. Because his verse in this song was so shitty, like most of the other songs he's in. Okay, enough of this bullshit. Y'all already know damn well that I cannot stand Young Thug most of the time. I mean, he's just another one of those talentless hacks, like Kodak Black and Lil Yachty and, Tyga, who else is there? I mean, I know that there's a lot of other newer whack rappers that I'm forgetting about, but... Okay, so the next song on the album is Inside Out. Alright, I'm hearing some pianos in the beat. It seems like Camila is experimenting with many different beats on this album, and I'm really living for it, bro. Hey, I like this. I love you inside out. Ooh. Man, I'm really getting into all of these songs, as y'all can tell. Oh, she's speaking Spanish, like she did in Sangria Wine with Pharrell Williams. Yeah, this song is so cool, and it sort of reminds me of the Chainsmokers song called Inside Out, which is another great song with a kick-ass beat. Ooh. Another feel-good type of beat. Okay, let's see. Consequences is the next song on this album. This song sounds like it'll be more slow and sad. I really love the meaning to all of these songs. I'm not gonna lie, this one is kind of hitting me very deep right now, man. Well, one of the most beautiful songs on this album so far, man. That was very beautiful. Okay, so this next one is Real Friends. I've been hearing lots of great things about this song, so I'm looking very forward to hearing it. Ooh, it sounds like it'll be a song with a guitar beat. Oh, I think I'll stay in conversations and the oh, I'm fine. No stranger to surprise. And try, give me a reason why. Ooh. I thought that I could trust you, never mind. Oh yeah, great lyrics, fight. Like always. Where do I draw a line from your friends? All they ever do is let me down. But nobody knows my name. But I'm just looking for some real friends. I love the meaning of this song with a passion. I mean, it's very important to always have real friends who always got your back, no matter what. So-called friends who leave you hanging when you need them the most are fake as hell. And we don't need shitty, dumbass people or so-called friends like that in our lives. Ooh. Words cannot express how much I really love that smooth, chill beats like this. So the next one after Real Friends is Something's Gotta Give. Okay, I'm spotting another piano beat once again. But I couldn't get no higher. Your November ain't gonna set the night on fire. Night on fire. You're next to me. Next to me. How do we get so far gone? I should know, but now we should know, but now. Yeah, her voice is like so peaceful to listen to. But all I do is give, and all you do is take. No worries, understand. It's a good reason to go. Oh yeah, another amazing feel-good beat, bro. Yes, all right, I love this. Yes. Now we just got two more songs to go. Next one is called In the Dark. Another song where the beat is off to a very great start. Could it be that all of the songs off this album are bops? I mean, so far we only got two songs left, and so far, like, all of them have been bops. I'm not gonna lie, bro, I can kind of relate to these lyrics. In the dark. And now the last one on this album is called Into It. Well, never mind, it's not the last one. The last one is technically Never Be the Same, the radio edit. But I've already heard the radio edit, so this one will be the last one I listen to. I'm sick on you, but you're the medicine too. Sometimes Camila Cabello reminds me of Ariana Grande at times. Both of them have very unique voices that are one of a kind. Ooh, this is another beat right here that I'm really feeling. I'm into it. Hey. Well, that album is definitely a masterpiece, bro. That was my reaction on Camila Cabello's debut album, Camila. I'm kind of pissed off at myself for not listening to it earlier. But 2018 has been a very busy year for me. So I hope y'all ain't too pissed off at me for doing a late reaction to this album. But I would say that my top 5 favorite songs off this album are Never Be the Same, Havana featuring his shitty-ass Young Thug, All These Years, She Loves Control, and Into It. I really hope y'all enjoyed my reaction to this album, and I'll just conclude this video by saying that this album is a bop, bro. Camila Cabello is awesome.